you're gonna act like a horse's ass, it might as well be a glittery one. Trooper, Friday, y'all. Super Bowl weekend action. Who gonna win the Super Bowl? Anybody know? I think I'm going to grab a quick bite of food. And then we're gonna get into a 2-5 game here at Bellagio. That's the plan anyway. Sometimes things don't go as planned, but maybe tonight they will.
Trey, you've gotta be kidding me, right?
I guess pretty awesome weather going. Mask mandate is gone. Super Bowl weekend action. What are we looking for here? What about Chick-fil-A? Chick-fil-A action might work. It's quick, it's cheap, it's easy, tastes pretty damn good. Pretty consistent. Let's do it. Look like the Popo is ready for a big weekend. Couldn't really find a place to sit at the Chick-fil-A. A lot of the tables are gone. We got some Chick-fil-A action down here in the police barricade action. Right down here. They better put my barbecue sauce in here, boy. Got them. Gotta have that barbecue action for the fries at Chick-fil-A. You gotta have it. Got that Chick-fil-A action going on a Friday. You saw that? All kind of one wheels and one wheel, no handle Segway, whatever you call them shits, right by the cops. Right through the whole police compound right here, and cops didn't say nothing. So everybody who thinks riding the boosted board on the strip is illegal, I don't think so. There's a lot of cops over there that could have at least said, yo, get off the street. They didn't say nothing. What does that tell you? I know it doesn't constitute law, but I'm just saying. So there's a question we always got to ask ourselves right after having Chick-fil-A and right before walking into the poker room to play poker. To coffee or not to coffee? I mean, I could just have a cinnamon sparkly heart instead, but there ain't no caffeine in that. There may only be 2 days left to order these and the cinnamon pops. But right now I'm thinking coffee. Let's do it. People will do anything for the TikTok video nowadays, won't they? Ha! Just kidding. Who knows what they're actually doing over there, but there's a dude playing drums. They're lighting him up. Oh, here comes what appears to be a bass guitar. I guess we're shooting a music video on the Bellagio parking garage. I don't know. Well, you can definitely tell it's Super Bowl weekend in the Bellagio poker room. Kind of busy. A lot of 2-5 games. My game was somewhere in the middle as far as the quality of the game goes. It wasn't super bad, but it wasn't super great. But there were players throughout the entirety of the session who were making the game okay. In one particular hand, well, first off, let me just say that I probably came in a little loose in the beginning. I played a hand with queens that I probably should have let go on the flop. Long story short, I had queens against aces and a set of deuces. About an hour ago, there was a player named on my right. Trooper, how you know his name is? Saw his player's card. When I raised to 20 preflop with pocket nines, got three callers, there was 80 in the pot, and the flop comes down jack, nine, six, rainbow, and it checks to me and I bet 25. And with a caller on my left, there's no better player in the entire Bellagio poker room, believe me when I tell you, that I would rather have check raised to $250 on my right than a... I don't know. Like I said, I just saw his name on the player's card. So when he made it 250, uh-oh, they got a drone in the air too. So I decide that it's probably best to just get it in now. Todd has a little over $200 behind. And I have him covered. I had 700 to start the hand. And the player on my left is probably not going much further. So I decide to move all in. And to my surprise, getting about 4-1, about $800 to his final 200 to call, thought about it. And he thought about it. And he thought about it. And then he finally shrugged and moved the other $200 in. I, being the gentleman that I was tonight, went ahead and rolled over my nines, and the dealer burned and turned a king and burned and rivered a queen for a jack, six, nine, king, queen board. And looked at his cards, and his wife behind him muttered something in Arabic, which she was doing nonstop, so who knows what the hell. And after a little bit of muttering back and forth, he tabled jack 10. Can't really complain. As I stated earlier, if there's any player you want to check raise to $250 when you flop middle set, it's and I decided to do that with a jack, top pair, 10 kicker, and then debate whether he wanted to call 200 more, and then somehow manages to run out some kind of crazy backdoor straight. So that was over $1,000 that went to stack. He left about 30 minutes later. So if anybody out there is in any way mathematically inclined and you understand odds and percentages and whatnot, my set of nines are 93.5 to 6.5. I have 93.5% equity on that flop, which means that if we play that hand 100 times, I stand to win 93.5 times and lose only 6.5 times. So I guess Friday night, Super Bowl weekend 2022 is one of the 6.5 times, if I'm ever lucky enough to get $1,000 pot built in a 2-5 game with a set of nines against jack 10 on the flop. I mean, how often do you even get that anymore in 2022? How often do you get a guy to check raise? I mean, this is not Jacksonville, Florida circa 2012, all right? Jacksonville, Florida, circa 2012, Jack 10 was going all in, all day, every day. So, yeah, what are you gonna do? You can't really complain, right? I mean, that was a dream, and if I didn't cash out, I wouldn't have cashed out. I decided to go ahead and call it a night because it is 1 a.m. and we have a long weekend ahead, 93 and a half. You know, I can look back through my days in Las Vegas playing poker since 2014, since I got here, and some of the largest pots that I have lost, it's always the huge pots, right? It's never like, oh, there's a guy with $100 and we get it all in and he somehow pulls it out as a, with 6.5% equity. It just never works that way. I will never, ever, ever in my life forget the hand at the win, which was, I had a set of fives against ace queen on a queen like 7-5 or something. Oh, I know why. I know why, because there was no way for this guy to run out straight. So he was only 3.5% because it was like jack, it was like queen 7-5. I have a set of fives against ace queen. The only way the guy can win is running out of boat or quads. And somehow he managed to run out ace queen. That guy was only 3.5%. That was a 1-3 game at the win for a $1,600 pot. And that was, who knows what year that was. If you're a huge fan of the vlog, you may remember that because it was one of the most brutal beats. But anyway, yo, the rest of the table seemed as though they had gotten kicked in the nuts, literally. But I just pulled out more money and added onto my stack and waited for the next hand to be dealt, because that's what you do. Crying about it's not going to change anything, but I get to tell you guys about it. I hate to tell you a bad beat story, but hey, you want to know how poker went tonight? That's how poker went tonight. I even forgot how much I'm down. $1,541. $1,541. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, leave a damn comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.